Setting up overlays for your vertical stream is a lot different than when you do it for horizontal because you're limited on the amount of space you can utilize. However, you still want your vertical streams to look professional. So today I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set up custom vertical overlays for your TikTok streams, your YouTube short streams, or any place that you want to stream vertical. And if you're new here, welcome to the Streamer Academy, where I help you start, create, and grow your stream. So go ahead and check out thestreameracademy.com for tons of resources to grow your stream. All right, so the first thing we're going to want to do is we want to have a vertical space to be able to stream vertically. So if you don't have that yet, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to aitum.tv/products/vertical #features. And again, I'll put a link in the description of this video. You'll simply come here and you'll download vertical. What this is going to allow us to do is to be able to have a place on OBS Studio where we can add in overlays and graphics and also stream vertical to these other platforms. So once you've gone ahead and installed this here, we're going to come back to OBS, and now you should see a vertical section here on the right hand side. If you don't see this, all you need to do is come to docs, select vertical scenes, vertical scenes, vertical sources, and toggle those on, and then you'll see these options here. Okay, so the first thing we're going to need is overlays. Now I have my katana horizontal overlays that I went ahead and got from Stream Designz. So again, you can come to streamdesigns.com to get all of your overlays to make your stream look professional. Again, I'll put a link in the description of this video. Now, again, what I'm utilizing is a horizontal package. I have the Katana package, but there's tons of options you can choose from to make sure that your horizontal streams that are going to Twitch, going to YouTube, going to Kick also match the vibe that you're sending over to YouTube Shorts or TikTok Live. So once you have your horizontal package, most of the time you're going to be able to find a matching vertical package that's custom and designed for vertical streaming. So again, I have the horizontal, but I'm going to go ahead and utilize the vertical package here. So the vertical package is going to give me everything that I need. It's going to give me my starting soon, my be right back, my ending soon, a countdown timer, my stinger transition, and a webcam overlay is what I'm going to be able to utilize. So you're going to see here, it's going to allow me to make everything look professional. And again, you can go ahead and find the package that meets your style, but I'm going to show you how to go ahead and get this set up now. So once you've gone ahead and got your package from Stream Designz, we're going to come back to OBS Studio. Now, when you got your files, okay, it's super important to remember that once you get your file from Stream Designz, you're going to want to unzip it to be able to get access to these files. So if you're on Windows, you really click extract, you'll unzip into a folder. If you're on Mac, you'll double click the zip file and be able to go ahead and utilize it. Again, when you download your package from Stream Designz, you'll get instructions on how to install it and download it so you can have access to it. So let's go ahead and begin. The first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to create a first scene. The first scene that we're going to go ahead and create is going to be our starting soon. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to rename this, and I'm going to name this starting soon vert. Okay, I'm going to press OK. And then we're going to come here to where it says sources. We're going to hit this little plus icon, and we're going to select media source. Okay, and media source is going to be for animated. If you're going to be utilizing a static, which the package comes with static and animated, so you can decide if you want it to not have no animation, you can use the static that comes inside the package, or you can use the vertical for the animation. And that's kind of what I prefer to be able to utilize. So I'm going to come to media source. I'm going to select new. Okay, I'm going to locate the file to where I downloaded from Stream Designz. So it's going to go on my desktop. I'm going to come here, vertical scene. I'm going to use the animated, and then we're just going to go ahead and do the starting soon. Now you have two options here. So the first one is the starting soon that without the countdown timer. So that's the first option that you have. The other option is to use the one with the countdown timer, and that's going to give you the one that has the starting soon and the countdown. So this is the one that I'm going to utilize for this version here. But again, you can go ahead and have the starting soon and then add the countdown timer. So if you wanted to do that, we'll start with the starting soon. Hit open. You want to make sure you loop it because it's only going to last 10 seconds. You want to make sure it keeps going, and then you want to press OK. Now you can start seeing here just how incredible this looks. It's actually custom and fit for vertical. You don't have to take the horizontal and stretch it down and adjust it. It's literally now set up to look professional on vertical as well. So we'll have that there. And then later, a little bit, I'll show you how to link it. So whenever you switch scenes inside of your horizontal side for Twitch or YouTube, it automatically switches for the vertical as well. So we're going to click this little plus icon again. We're going to name a new source. course, and we're gonna name this Countdown Birthday. Press OK. We're then gonna go ahead and come here to the plus icon. We're gonna go Media Source again. We're gonna select New, and we're gonna Browse again, right? So we're gonna come back to our file, and we're gonna click the Countdown Timer one here. You're gonna select Open, and for the Countdown Timer, you don't select Loop, because once the timer's done, you wanna switch over to your next scene. You'll press OK, and now you can see that we have our Countdown Timer, right? So here's the Countdown Timer on the horizontal, and now here's the Countdown Timer on the vertical. Again, looking professional and making everything look cohesive. Super important that you have professional looking stream, no matter if you're on vertical or horizontal. So now we're gonna go ahead and add in our next scene. So our next scene is gonna be our gameplay. Okay, so we're gonna do gameplay. And this is probably the one of the most important ones, because this is where people are gonna spend the most amount of time, right? So here, we're going to go ahead and bring in our gameplay. Now, since I already have my gameplay on my horizontal, I'm just gonna bring that in. However, if you'd wanted to bring it in separately, I would just come to Video Capture Device, I would select New, I would select my device, which is my HD60X, okay, which is there, okay, and I would have it on high, and I would press OK. Now you can see here that I have it here in the center. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna right click, I'm gonna hit Transform, and I'm gonna rotate 180, right? So now it's gonna be here centered. Now what I can do is that I can make this as big as I possibly can, and then right click, hit Transform, and then I wanna hit Center to Screen, okay? So there's in the center, and I can bring this down, and let's say this is where I want my gameplay to be able to be. Now, we have this space at the top, which is gonna be for our webcam. So we want to go ahead and add our webcam, and we also get a webcam overlay. So what I'm gonna do here for the time being is I'm gonna just turn this off for a second, I'm gonna lock it, and we're gonna go ahead and add in our camera. So I'm gonna add in a camera. So again, we're gonna come here to Video Capture Device, I'm gonna add New, I'm gonna select my camera, which is gonna be my cam link. Okay, there's my camera there. I'm gonna press OK, I'm gonna right click, I'm gonna first go ahead and hit Transform. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and rotate it 180 degrees, and then I'm gonna right click, hit Transform, and I'm gonna hit Fit to Screen. Okay, so again, I'm gonna hit Transform again, rotate 180, and now we have this here. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna hold the Alt key on my Windows or Option, and I'm just gonna go ahead and lower this here so I can have some space. So I'm gonna bring this to the top, okay, and just leave it there. And now we want to add in our webcam overlay. So to be able to do that, we're gonna click this little plus icon, we're gonna come to Media Source, we're gonna hit New, and then we're gonna locate that webcam overlay. So you'll see here, webcam overlay, we'll hit Open. You do want this to loop because it is animated. We'll press OK, and now we have it here. So what we wanna do is, again, I'm gonna lock my camera so I can make sure I'm working with the right file, hit Transform, and I wanna hit Fit to Screen as well, okay? So now here's the border. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab this, I'm just gonna size it to be the length of my camera, okay? Just to have that nice border. Again, I'm just gonna size this up, okay? And there we go. So now I have that in place. All right, so what I wanna do now is I want to go ahead and open up my game so I can see it again. And then I'm gonna go ahead and start with the webcam. So I'm gonna grab the webcam, I'm gonna bring it up to where it needs to be. Then I'm gonna lock it, and then I'm gonna bring over my webcam overlay up to the top as well, okay? Now I have it in place where I want it to be. And again, you can decide where you want this to be. I'm gonna bring down my camera just a little bit more. I'm gonna place it there. And now I have my gameplay, I have my camera, and now it's looking professional. So now we have our webcam overlay, which is nice little graphic. We have our gameplay here. So when I'm moving, you can be able to see it. So we'll have that in place, I'll lock it. So far we've set up our starting soon, okay? We've set up our countdown timer, and we've set up our gameplay. The next thing you see is that whenever I switch scenes, right, it's giving me a weird kind of stinger transition. When I switch on my horizontal, you see I have that kind of animation. And that's the same thing we want, because again, we want consistency. So we're gonna click on stinger. We're gonna hit this little plus icon. We're gonna go ahead and select stinger, and we're gonna name this stinger vert. Press OK. We're going to go ahead and browse, and we're going to select the stinger transition that we have here. We'll add that there. And again, transition point, this is going to be a little bit different based on what we have. So I'm just going to put 1500 here, and this we can just tweak it to see what's going to work, and you can hit preview. And the idea here is to see B towards the end, right? And that's kind of where we're at right there. And then audio, you want to select crossfade. We'll press OK. And now you're going to see here that when I switch scenes, we have that nice animation that happens, right? So now again, you're starting to see that this is custom for your vertical scenes, right? So now what we want to do is we want to add in our Be Right Back and our stream offline. So we'll hit this little plus icon. We're going to name this BRB Vert. Press OK. And again, the idea here is to give you some customization to make your verticals look professional as well. So we'll come to Media Source. We'll hit New. We'll browse that. And again, this is all inside of your file. So we'll come to Be Right Back. Hit Open. We will select Loop. We'll press OK. And now you see here that we have our Be Right Back option as well. And then the last one that we'll go ahead and add here is going to be ending soon, and then we'll name this vert. You'll press OK, and then we'll come here to the plus icon, like Media Source, select New, Browse, and then you want to select your ending soon. Press open. We do want to go ahead and loop this. We'll have this in place here. Now here's the beautiful thing, right? So now you have a fully professional looking scene. However, you don't want to have to switch between managing a horizontal and managing a vertical. You just want that whenever you switch scenes, no matter whether you're horizontal or vertical, it automatically updates. To be able to do this, what we're going to do, we're going to right click on starting soon, and you're going to see where it says linked scene. We're going to link this to our starting soon, right? So that's linked now. We're going to right click on countdown. We're going to go to linked. We're going to select countdown timer. Okay, we're going to go to gameplay. We're going to right click. We're going to say linked, and we're going to link to the gameplay. We're going to come here to be right back. We're going to link, be right back. We're going to go to ending soon. We're going to go to linked, and we're going to select offline. Okay, so now what's going to happen is here, take a look at this. When I switch to the countdown timer on my horizontal, it's going to do the same thing on my vertical. When I go to my gameplay, it's going to go here to my gameplay. Okay, and the one scene that you don't have is a just chatting. So for just chatting, what I typically like to do is come here, just chatting, press okay. And then what I like to do is just bring in just the camera by itself. Okay, this is the opportunity to just be able to chat. And if you want, you can also bring in the chat there. So I'm just going to come to media source. I'm going to click scene, and I'm just going to go ahead and select just chatting and have my camera be here. Make this bigger. And then what we'll do here is just like this, bring in your camera. And now you have your camera where you're talking directly to your viewers. And then you right click scene, just chatting. And again, when we come here to the be right back, okay, let's just go here, be right back. Make sure this is linked to the right one. There we go. Okay, so now when we go to offline, you're gonna see here on the vertical, it's gonna go offline. When we go to gameplay, it's gonna happen here. So just like that, you now have a professional looking vertical stream. However, if you don't have a horizontal setup like the way that I have it, and you don't have anything to be able to link, you want to go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on adding all of your overlays for your horizontal streams, for Twitch, for YouTube, how to add alerts, how to add labels, how to add chat, everything you need to make your stream look professional. Click that video right there, and I'll see you in the next one.